old Jet Braves Ferraro in just a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich, and we have a team tonight that is coming off a win. Probably feel pretty good about themselves. What do you tell them?
Well, you tell them, let's play the same way we did in the prior game, Doc. They did everything that they wanted to get accomplished. They managed the puck extremely well. They got timely goals. They played really well without the puck in their own zone. And let's worry about what we can do, not necessarily what the other team's strengths are.
The Devils got to stick to the game plan here tonight, Doc. They played a real good team game in their prior win. One of the reasons for that, they had great communication both on and off the ice. Let's see if that continues here tonight. Okay, so let's look at the starting goaltenders for the game. He's getting tons of work, but that's the lot of the goalie, and he likes it for the Penguins. On the last one, so he starts this one. As we're about to begin, Sidney Crosby's won everything possible in the game of hockey. Now he'll see if he can win this faceoff. He's on the ice to put on another show in front of these fans. And we have just begun.
New Jersey's hard work in their last game paid off as they added another plus to the win column. Stick to the plan tonight and you will be rewarded.
Play halted down to the ice and right.
For the most part, this is the easiest division travel-wise. Man, these guys can go around most of the time in a bus if they want to. But the competitive balance makes it a really difficult division.
Thanks very much, Rich.
And the linesman waves off icing. He got there first. Great save in close.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender Roger couldn't stop.
That was a big hit.
Well, you got to love that early hit, Doc. You get to the rink, you want to set a tone for your team if you can, and an early hit is one way to do it.
Collected in the corner. They've got all the gunners out. Sends it down low. Pass behind the net. Good work. Still hasn't paid off yet. Great opportunity, but the pass didn't connect. Odd man rush, 2-on-1. At least he protected his goaltender.
Well, Tang's nicked up here. Guys, he's going to have to finish his shift. They're stuck in their own zone.
Looks from the corner. Got it on his stick in the slot. A strong pass stop there. Right near the goal stripe to Zajac. Poked away. Lobs it. Batted away. Recollected. Directing that one to Hornquist. And he dumps it in. And the pickup. He left his feet, but not on his own, and not by choice.
Great play along the boards. Tries to rain out his man by throwing the body.
He's got that pass at the point. That's a free puck thanks to the play by Kessel. Gathered up again by Boyle. Gathered up again by Hornquist. Driving in from no man's land. And he holds on and stops.
Tang's laid it all out on the line. He was injured earlier in the shift, still had enough jam to get out and block the shot.
A little under 9 minutes have transpired. Still nothing on the score sheet yet. Off that faceoff from the tie-up, the help came. Gains the zone. Has it picked up. Sliced through the neutral zone. And try! The redirect went wide. Oh, it was a good idea, though. Tried, but it didn't work. The Penguins have it along the side at thin ice. Gathered up by Brisson. May not have intended it, but it hit it. Pitching this one to Coleman. With a shot. Terrific shot by Steve.
Locker room, is they're going to be short a player for the rest of the night. The injury occurred a while ago. He will not return.
Puck dropped and the winger stepped in to help. That's big. Takes it in from the neutral zone. Great poke check there.
Does he play with the stick?
Right now, so...
Kept away by Green. From the outside, he wore that puck on a hard shot. The Penguins with a neutral zone possession along the way. And that pass really misfired, and so they must drop back. All the pressure still on as they can't clear. Tries to get it on net. Great glove save. Cuts off that pass in the attacking zone.
Let's hope that there's lots more going to happen here other than what we've seen in the first part of this game. The teams are gently prodding and trying to find an opening, but there's not much going on.
They continue to work away. Dogged determination there by Palmieri. New Jersey's carrying it up the wing. Zajac's got to try to simplify his game there. Just too much dickhead. Shoots one. Lays it high off the post. That puck sails out of play and into the lap of a lady from Shewinton. Solid win at center ice. Now what? Brings it in for an attack. Trying to go to Kessel. Nearing the 20th minute of this period. Oh, he got that! Moving it to Brand for Slid to Butcher. Good job done with the stick. Way to break up that play. Makes that play deep. Shoots one. Wonderful save. Period number one has been completed. Neither team got scoring. Some chances, no success. The Penguins have their backs to the wall because they may be shorthanded due to this play that has injured one of their players. We'll check to see if he returns when we come back after this.
I actually kind of like that. It really does take some amount of skill to get out of the line. But it's not like you're big.
Second period about to begin here. Let's take a look back at the first. What stuck out for you?
So we head to the second dock with no score. I would imagine both coaches would like to see more shots, more people, more traffic. And when you do that, you create second and third chance opportunities, making life difficult for the goaltenders.
Lawful boarding. And puck's loose, collected away by Taylor Hall. Loose puck did not go very well there. Puck is thrown to Rust. Can't start the attack going in the zone. Goes back deep for it. Right to the point. Skates along the line. Great job on a cut pass.
That's not bad.
Gensel's hooked on this play, and the eye of the referee is guilty of a minor penalty for using the stick play. Just a hook. Pittsburgh's power play will have its first chance of the game. Jersey's prevailed on another faceoff.
Chasing the game is a losing proposition night after night. You get on the board first, you win way more than you lose. A power play can give you that advantage.
Okay.
Looking to Kessel. Crosses that line. Laid on to Crosby. Score! A power play goal, and it's a biggie.
Always interesting. Whether the team that scored is going to continue to attack, or whether they'll sit back a little
bit. The Penguins have taken the lead by one. What fork in the road are we headed for with this faceoff? The Devils control from the neutral zone. And he's tripped, and they'll be up back to play in their own end as the clock ticks down on the power play. The stick can break up a play, and it just did. Pittsburgh's gotten it back out. They check the clock, get ready to defend. Passing one off now to Botman. Pass attempt to Palmieri. Let's it go. Wonderful chance to score, but no. Really good cut of the pass. A good clear, and now some relief in the line change. Now it's directed to Heischer. The Devils' power play has ended. What a great chance to tie the game.
This could really be frustrating for the coaches and the players on the bench when your power play doesn't find a way to come through for you. You have a chance to tie the game, and you just can't get it.
On the outside, a shot. Score! And the game is even.
I'd say this game is played out pretty much according to plan. Both teams have been really focused on the defensive side of the puck. It has been pretty physical, and when there are chances, the goals have been sharp.
The Penguins have control of the puck in the defensive zone.
Intercepted and in no man's land.
Okay, guys, I'm back.
Back on a stick. Compel to Butcher.
Let's it go. That puck's trucking in front.
In this game, there is actually kind of a strategy.
Missed alone.
Has it back deep.
It's basically, if there are three fruits.
Long lead pass to Malkin. Missed on that.
They're going to be out.
Sends to the point. Couldn't get his way through.
And they choose two.
He had high hopes.
Crosby's been among the most dangerous players in the league.
He's gone!
Gotten a one-goal lead and lots of time left in the game. We're still in period number two. The puck's dropped, and that's a great job tying the man up on that faceoff. It's ducked in. And the puck heads to the neutral zone, and so everybody has to get reset. A collision! I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game. Gensel's picked up. That should be a penalty. The Devils have been handed a minor penalty for tripping. He's got great stick positioning. Stick is on the ice, but unfortunately takes the skates out from under him.
Okay, let's get to our next mini game, please.
Pittsburgh's power play has been strong. They have connected once. Let's see if they can make it twice on this power play.
I like your setup on the power play that scored earlier, Doc. Let's see if they can get it set up again. Just to kind of turn around for a couple of new chances.
Snapping a pass to Hornquist.
Okay, let's play some more. Unfortunately, I think.
Carried to the corner by Brassard. Wonderful block. He signs the line. And that one is cleared for time off that penalty clock as they drop back and wait for another run. Pittsburgh's back in its own end.
go Gray in the hurry.
Green's tripped and a penalty should be coming. Pitching it to Johansson. A shot. Snyder's at the bench. Extra attacker out. The Penguins suffer a tripping call. I'm going to give credit to the puck carrier. He kept his legs moving. He forced the back checker to reach in and take him off his feet. The Devils' power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
You're not going to get an endless supply of power plays, but they get another one here. See if they can punch through.
He got rid of it. A loose, strong defensive play by Hagel. Steps across that line. Penguins have forced another turnover. They've done a real nice job in that category in this postgame.
The Devils have been hoping for a streak like this for some time. But how could they imagine it would go on for this long? Another excellent night adding to this lengthy point scoring streak.
Barely avoided it.
New Jersey's got another win. Fires! What a save! I was looking for the light to go on. Over 3 minutes to go here in the set. We were tied, and now it's a one-goal game. From the faceoff, and they lock up, and a good reach. That's help from the wing. The power play unit has to recoil and try yet again.
I was going to keep the pressure on trying to get inches outside of the actual goal.
A drop, face off one, and the winger stepped right in. Directing that one to Hall. Sinks in. At the point, big shot. New Jersey's power play fails this time, and so they are still down by one.
That penalty killing group was like a well-oiled machine. They moved at the right time. They worked with Sink and the goaltender made any saves that he had to.
The cursed goals are the ones in the first minute and the last. Will we see one here? In with it now. Shoots one. And a save. Oh, and the puck winds up back at center ice. Mitch. Patchen's one. Oh, close but wide.
Now that was an exciting moment. I thought he was going to score it, but he just puts that puck wide from the slot.
Strong wrist shot. A brilliant save at the horn. 40 minutes have been played here, and still more to go. A well-deserved rest is at hand. We take a look at the shots on goal through two periods. 13 for the Devils, and 12 for the Penguins. Pittsburgh's one-goal lead came on this play. We'll show it to you one more time as we go to break.
I just realized I have two stars. So I have a pretty good lead right now. I've hit the hat in space twice now, so I'm actually going to be pretty good. And I'm on my way to
40 minutes down, at least 20 minutes to go. What are your thoughts so far?
The Devils have had the better of the play, Doug, especially in the category of time of possession. They're down in this third period, but they have to start finishing off some of their chances.
Leads that charge into the zone. He imposed his will. New Jersey's controlling play now through neutral ice. To the backhand and shoots. Save there. Pitching this one to Gensel. He's got it. New Jersey's setting up an offense from the wing. Play is offside. Back to center ice.
And I got this dude.
Face off, he ties his man up, and so the puck goes to his team. Shoots. No luck.
Hit the net. The puck is in the middle of the ice. You've got to get it on the boards.
Puck ricocheting on the screen. What a rip from the point. Great save. Pressure now. Gains that offensive line. Looking from the corner. The Penguins luck that long in their own end. Trying to go to Hornquist. Good place to shoot from, and he does. Wonderful stop. Gets a little drop off from the goalie here.
Okay, let's do some points.
He
begins the zone. On to Zajac. Takes it right back. He covers and holds on. Just over 6 minutes have been played, and it is 2-1 the score in this one. The Devils prevail again. And a save. Puck is thrown to Brassard. The Penguins are driving it from the wing. He recollects it. Some contact there, and the puck is loose. Good play by Hagman. Loose puck knocked away by Brassard. Gets in, and he'll look over his options. Slid.
And the puck gets out.
Let's it go. Made the save. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a face-off.
There's not much behind that. The goalie will make that stick save every day.
Good clean win on the draw.
Now,
back to the point. Gives it on a cross from the point. Outstanding save. Holy, great chance. Collected by Kuhn. Referee's got a penalty on his mind here. Delayed call. Looking to nose it. Puck's loose, mishandled. The Devils get their goal into the bench for the extra man. The Penguins get 2-4 boarding.
And I said the same trap.
These are the type of plays, Doc, that we want to eliminate from the game where the attacking player has no chance to protect himself when getting hit from behind.
This power play is too predictable. They have to find a way to change it up. I agree entirely, Eddie. Let's see if they prove us right here.
There's not much new to a power play. It works the same way all the time. You get a good zone entry, you get the puck to the point, you shoot it, you move the penalty killers around. Let's see if they can do it this time.
Save there. What a shot! That shot's blocked. Who's puck cleared? A hit on that last thing. Come on. Chooses a corner for this. Muscled long to run. Really good job by the defenseman there. What a save. What a great scoring chance in a slot. The goalie got on top of that in a hurry. Great club save. And it's a pleasure to bring in the third voice on our crew. Ringside, here's Ray Ferraro.
They say goaltending's 50% of the game, guys. Unless you don't have good goaltending, then it's 80%. It has been more than 50% brilliant tonight. I watched these all night. What a great performance.
He has been remarkable tonight, Ray. It's going to be one of my three stars of the game, maybe the first.
It's going to be a risk.
Good setup off the win. The pass is off the mark. What a chance that would have been. He finally got it out. Passing one off now to Button.
I know lots of people like high-scoring games. Well, actually, I'm one of them. But this has been almost like a one-play chess match. There's no room. There's no way that either team can find a way to get many more chances in those games.
Pass attempt to Kessel. Steps in from the neutral zone. Fires a shot. Oh, what a chance. What a save. A long scorcher. He created a screen, but he blocked the shot. Recollected. New Jersey's got possession in the defensive zone. He blocks it down and keeps it alive. Really solid possession and pressure. Not done yet, though. Slid back across from one point to the other. Shoots one. Broke it right up. All part of generating an offense. Little pass off from the goal. Nicely into the zone. Picks it up in his own end. Played on. Receives that pass from the other side. Great save, point blank.
The goalie puts that hit to use and takes it away. The best teams in the league find a way to win during the toughest parts of the schedule. They have a tough schedule coming up. They have a string of games upcoming in their schedule. They're going to test it as a team.
Can't make it. Come on. Yes, new record.
You can't pick a better time to win a
All
draw.
Right.
Using the point.
Only good things come to the
same. Propel to Segerson. Oh, broken up.
And that
backhander to the net.
Position.
Fends on Howitzer.
Maybe.
Picked up by the defense. And he steps in. From the outside. A terrific scoring chance tonight. Baker Eye. At least he protected his goal test. Last minute to go in the third. He lifted the stick and chicked his pocket. Now it's directed to Severson. The Devils go for broke. Their goalie is pulled.
That was a pretty good handle in this game.
Take it away.
We'll see.
Hart's got it on his stick, trying to get it out of there. Snapping a pass to
Hart.
And quickly back. Shoots it off. Great save. Makes the stop and holds.
I'd like to say that the shooter was shooting for a rebound. At least I hope he was, because that shot had no chance of going in.
That's why Mario's in second place.
Does not get any more dramatic than this.
Four feet by six.
Yawning open at one end, hoping for an advantage at the other. Back and forth they go between the points. That puck hit him on the way to the net. And that's the end of this one. The game has ended. The Devils lost this game, but you remember that. The stats say they should have won.
Especially in a face-off circle, they dominated that statistic. And when you do that, you usually win, but not tonight.
What a terrific game of hockey. Well played by now. Very tired players. A great time. We hope you enjoyed it. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night all.
I kind of got bored with it.